Hi there. Today we are going to talk about the financial statements. So what are financial statements? These are documents that tell you about the current standing of the financial standing of the company. How the company is performing, has performed over a period of time, all these details regarding the company are framed in financial statements. These statements you will study in detail as we move on into further videos of financial analysis. For now, you just have to know the different types of financial statements and their uses. Who uses it? The creditors, those who give loans to the company, they want to assess the company's standing. The shareholders, the existing ones who want to assess how the company performs or how is it going to perform in valuing securities, takeovers, mergers, future forecasting. Every person and many more use financial statements for different purposes. So there are different types of financial statements. The first one is income statement. Income statement is performed over a period of time. It portrays the performance, profit and loss of a company over a period of time. This is also known as the P&L statement or the income and expenses statement. The next in line is balance sheet. We follow a double entry accounting system while framing the balance sheet. The accounting equation for this is A is equal to L plus E. The extended accounting equation is something that is part of your CFA curriculum and should be taken quite seriously by the candidate. We'll discuss this in the following chapters after this video too. Cash flow statement is the next in line. It shows the reconciliation of cash. So in the balance sheet, there is a column for how much cash a company has. So if a company has 10 lakh of cash, 10 millions of cash in, let's say, 2010 and 12 million in 2012. So a cash flow statement will tell you how it reached from 10 million to 12 million. From where did cash come in or where did the cash go? So it reconciles the cash statement from one balance sheet period to the other. Cash flow can come from different activities, either operating, investing and financing. As an example, let's consider General Motors. If they are selling their cars, that would be regarded as an operating cash flow activity. If they invest in a new plant, that would be an investing cash flow activity. And if they go out to the share market to raise more money via debt or the selling of shares, that would be a financing cash flow activity. So these are the three types of cash flow activity. All the cash flow activities are defined under these three headings, and this reconciles with the balance sheet. Statement of changes in stockholders' equity is the last one. So apart from the three sheets that we have mentioned, it is self-explanatory and shows you how the stockholders' equity pattern has changed over a period of time. This is not part of extensive study in the CFA curriculum, though you may encounter this from time to time. So it shows you how much is the ownership of the people and reconciliation of return earnings and everything comes under the stockholder equity. So there's some important points to keep in mind while studying this chapter. Importance of footnotes. These show areas like contingency liabilities framed by the company. So footnotes are there in every statement that is made, like balance sheet and income statement. And these are not prevalent in other MDA and other kind of statements, but these are prevalent in balance sheet and income statement. So they contain areas like contingency liabilities, which tell you actually how the assumptions have been made by while coming to the accounting conclusion. Next in line is MDA. MDA and A stands for Management Discussion and Analysis. This is again a financial statement. However, this is not audited by the external auditors. And this is normally which is analysts use before coming to other financial statements to look at the purview of the company from the perspective of the directors or from the perspective of the management of how they view the company, the situation of the company, the future prospects, the liquidity and etc. External audit report. Every company has to appoint an external auditor. More often than not, this is appointed by the shareholders on a general management meeting every year. And these people conduct a survey based on sampling that assures you that the financial statements being conducted are of reasonable quality and they are not being fudged. So this is just a reasonable assurance, not a total assurance, because this is just based on sampling. And they then give their opinion, that is unqualified, qualified, adverse or disclaimer. Unqualified is the best opinion that a company can get. It means that these statements have been made perfectly in the manner that they should be. Qualified is a statement that is issued if the external auditor agrees that the statement are fine, but for clause that actually flouts the rule, and in that case they give a qualified opinion where they agree that even though the statement may be right, there is some aspect of it that does not agree with the accounting principle, then they would give a qualified opinion. Adverse opinion, obviously, as the name suggests, is something that when they do not agree with the opinion, with the financial statements and the data being provided by the company. And the last is disclaimer of opinion. This is mentioned when there is not enough data for the external auditors to process. So they are not in the position to actually give any opinion, they actually give a disclaimer of opinion. The most important aspect of an external auditor is to ascertain whether the estimates and assumptions are correct. The business is obviously established on a public concern basis, and sometimes the companies tend to make a scenario where they realize profit even before it has been achieved by them. So they tend to overlook all these aspects and find out whether the assumptions have been made correctly. And under US GAAP, that is generally accepted accounting principles which are prevalent in US. So the external auditor also has to give an opinion upon the internal control mechanism to minimize the chances of fraud. This is not a case under IFRS. Another financial statement is the proxy statement, and it tells you what are we voting for, what are the shareholders voting for. So the management has to send a proxy statement to the SEC in the case of US and similar authority in other countries. So they have to tell you what the vote will be for, what will be the director compensation and other aspects. So, and the last is statement of comprehensive income. This statement is not compulsory under IFRS or US GAAP, but this is something that you will deal while preparing income statement and how the necessary entries are made while making the statement. The last part of this chapter is financial statement analysis and the various stages involved. So we start off obviously by defining the purpose of analysis, what are we trying to achieve. Then we go around collecting data. Then we process that data, we do analysis of various kinds like ratio analysis to determine the standing of the company. But that is not enough. The next step, interpreting the processed data, is more important.